Welcome to STAT 151 Online. My name is Karen Benway, and I'll be your instructor this summer. This video is to help you learn how to navigate our Blackboard page so that you can get off to a good start. The first thing you'll see when you log into Blackboard are the announcements. I'll use the announcements as the primary method of communicating to the entire class as a group. I'll send an announcement out every week on the beginning of a module to make sure that you know what's expected of you during the week. Next, we'll take a look in the Start Here folder. The Start Here folder is the place to begin looking through everything you need to know to make sure that you have all your questions answered about the class, and if you don't, make sure you always ask me. First, you'll see a list of some things to do to get yourself off to a good start. Then there's a link to this video so that if there's something that you forget how to do or where to find, you can always refer back to the video. Next, there's a little information about scanning handwritten work because that's going to be an important thing to be able to do so that you can submit your work during the semester. Finally, there's a little bit of information about the course content. You want to make sure that you read the syllabus and the course schedule completely. They can be found in this tab with the syllabus and course schedule. Just click on the link to open the syllabus or the course schedule. I advise you to read them both thoroughly. This is the only way that you can make sure that you have all of the information and know what all of the due dates will be for the semester. The next tab you'll see is the course materials. In the course materials, you'll find all the modules that we'll complete. This week we're going to be completing two modules, Module 0, which is just a couple day introduction, and Module 1, which will cover the first two sections of the textbook. Module 0 needs to be completed by Tuesday, May 23rd at 11:59 p.m. The things that you're going to need to do are to read and or watch all the materials in the Start Here folder, read the syllabus and the course schedule, and then you will draw a self-portrait. It does not matter how good it is, we're not an art class, but then you're going to want to scan it and save it as a .pdf file. And the reason I ask you to do this is because, first of all, it's kind of fun, but second of all, it's important to make sure that right away you figure out how you're going to scan your handwritten work. The next thing you're going to do is introduce yourself to the entire class on the Help discussion board and attach your PDF file with your self-portrait there, and we'll look at how to do that in just a minute. Then afterwards, you're going to click on the Group tab and go to your Group discussion board and create a thread there. And I ask you to do these things just to make sure that you know how to use the important tools before we get started. Next, we'll look at how to use the Help discussion board. In the Help discussion board, there will be forums for each module. Usually, the module will be a place to ask questions about the course material or the homework, and I ask students to post their questions here instead of just sending an email, because first of all, this discussion board will automatically notify me by email anytime someone asks a question. But also, it gives you an opportunity to learn from your classmates' questions, and it also gives your classmates an opportunity to learn from your questions. So please post questions about the course material to the Help discussion board. For this week, the first module, Module 0, we're actually going to post an introduction. And to post, what we do is we click on the forum name and then click Create Thread. Then you can type in your post. After giving it a title, you can type your text down here. If you want to attach a file, click on the little paperclip. And then browse your computer until you find the file that you want to attach. I'm just going to choose any old file. Submit, and it will attach the file. There is also an equation editor here that you can use if you ever want to enter mathematical notation. And various other tools. Once you've finished writing your post, you click Submit, and there it is. When you want to reply to a post or read a post, you click on the name of the thread, click Reply, type your response, and submit. The next tab you'll see is the Quizzes tab. Each week there will be a quiz that will be available beginning on Sunday at noon and will be due on Tuesday night at 11:59 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The quizzes will appear in this folder, and the first week there will be a video making sure that you know how to submit the quizzes. There's a tab for students who are preparing for the actuarial exam, with a variety of information about taking the actuarial exam, some practice questions, and a whole bunch of other stuff. And of course, you can find your grades. The very last thing I want to show you on our Blackboard page is how to use your homework discussion group. If you look down at the bottom of the page where it says My Groups, can see your homework group. You may be in group 1 or group 2. Once I click on it, I can say, okay, I want to go to my group discussion board. Your first assignment is going to be to go to your group discussion board and post there. You'll create a thread with your first and last name as the title. If you want to type something else in as a message, that's fine. If not, you can just submit. If you ever need to, you can also email the members of your group by clicking on the Send Email link. Hopefully this video gets you off to a good start and helps answer your questions about how to get around in our Blackboard page. But always remember that anytime you have a question, please let me know. You can either post to the Help Discussion Board if it's something general that you think would benefit the whole class, or if it's something more personal and you really don't feel comfortable posting there, you can always send me an email as well. Thanks and have a good day!